back to Swiss Home Garden, Chitra here. In this video, I will be showing you how to make baklava. This is a traditional sweet from the Middle East, also well known in Greece, Turkey and in the Balkan areas. I first had this when I was traveling in Turkey many years back. And after that, I have had it with a few of my friends over here and I've learned to bake it myself. Let's get started on making baklava.
For making the baklava, you will need 450 grams of filo pastry. I got this filo pastry sheets from the local supermarket here, Co-op. They have it in the speciality section and you can find them easily, or you try to find it in some of this Middle Eastern or Balkan speciality stores in your local area. I haven't yet found an organic filo pastry here yet, so I will have to make do with this. Traditionally, baklava is made with pista nuts. Since I don't have that much of unsalted pista nuts, I will be using a mixture of walnuts and pista nuts. 250 grams of walnuts and pista nuts. 250 grams of melted unsalted butter. 350 grams of caster sugar. 250 milliliters of water. And the juice of half a lemon for the flavoring. Heat your oven to 180 degrees centigrade. In the meantime, melt the butter and set it aside. All the ingredients I'm using here are organically grown except the filo pastry. I haven't yet tried to attempt to make filo pastry. I guess it's a very difficult process, so I just take the easier route of buying it in the supermarket. Chop the nuts finely by hand or blitz them in a food processor. Since chopping by hand takes a long time, I will be using my hand grater for this purpose. I prefer to use this hand grater so it doesn't alter the molecular structure due to heat. You will need a deep rectangular baking dish. Brush the baking dish with a little bit of the melted butter. Place a sheet of the filo pastry carefully in the bottom of the baking dish and brush it with the melted butter. If needed, cut the filo pastry to fit to the dish. Even if the filo pastry cracks or breaks while layering, it doesn't matter as it will set in once you brush it with the butter and then when the sugar syrup is added towards the end. Place another sheet of the pastry on top and brush the surface again with melted butter. Repeat this until you have used half of the pastry sheets. After layering half of the filo pastry sheets, add in all the chopped nuts in a single layer. Save a little bit of the pista nuts for the garnish later. Layer the remaining filo pastry on top of the nuts, brushing each layer with the melted butter. Once you have brushed the top with the melted butter, cut through the layers into diamond shapes using a sharp knife. Bake in the preheated oven for 25 to 30 minutes until the baklava is golden and crisp. Set aside to cool completely. Now we will be making the syrup. For the syrup, add the sugar, water, lemon juice into a pan and heat gently, stirring until the sugar is completely dissolved. Bring the syrup to a simmer and simmer for 15 minutes. Pour the hot syrup over the cooled baklava and leave it to cool before cutting it again and serving. Garnish the baklava with the chopped pista nuts. It tastes best when it has rested for 24 hours.
I hope you enjoyed watching this video and thank you for watching. In case you are new to my channel, kindly subscribe. I post one new video every week on food from scratch, Swiss country living and our gardening experiences. And don't forget to hit the bell button to receive notifications for the latest videos I've uploaded. Many interesting stuff is coming up, not so much in the gardening side. Until next time, bye bye.